Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. You may be wondering why we haven't posted as many videos lately as we usually have. That's because we've published over 23 books. Yes, we've been busy. If you want to take a look at what we've been up to, you can go to RevoBooks.com and you can see what we do in our spare time. Also, we took on a big project out in the front, digging up lilies of the valley that got wild and woolly, and that took almost 2 weeks. We're finally done with it today. I can just sit back now and enjoy the flowers that we've planted there. A couple of people have asked if we could take a little walk around and see what June looks like in Wisconsin. Yesterday we were busy too because we were working the polls where we had our major recall election for Scott Walker, and we've been in the news for that too, but thankfully we haven't been in the news. Come on, follow me. We can actually now see the plants that we have. We specialize in specimen plants, things that we find interesting. And we had them all in there, but we couldn't see them because of the ferns and the lilies of the valley and bindweed and all sorts of things. So now we have been able to see that. And for my husband's birthday, I even got him some lawn ornament. There's one. And then my husband got me these happy little birds that chase each other around and balance and talk to one another, just like Rick and me.
Do we talk to each other?
We do.
Oh.
And sometimes we scold. I told them they look like angry birds to me, but maybe not.
And what did I do to their wings?
You opened them up a little bit so the wind could catch them and they could twirl a little bit more. Mm-hmm. So that was another fun addition to the yard. Now, starting about here, all the way down this morning, that's what I worked on today. We bought all these beautiful annuals that add such beautiful color to the yard, and they've been sitting in their little containers waiting. So today was the day.
So it looks like you put in a couple hundred.
It seems like I put in 1,000.
And then this area?
This area, we reclaimed a tree. Our tree here that we planted last year had, I don't know what kind of huge weeds that were almost as tall as I was. So we got those out. Now I can breathe again and our little river birch can grow happily. And I found my hostas back again and put some more mulch down. Make everything look like it belongs together. We had transplanted. You might see the coreopsis there looks a little wilty. That's because it was transplanted. That we found we had to do a lot of that too because of all the roots that were intermingled. My hostas are looking good. I see no slug holes at the moment, although there look like a few over there. But for the most part, they're pretty good.
Now, is this where you've been using diatomaceous earth?
No, this is where I was using cinnamon because of the fungus that had attacked their roots earlier in the spring. So it seems not to be bothering them, and maybe we caught it in time to save the plants. They look happy. Now this little area gets a lot of sun during the day. Right now it's probably the shadiest time for it. But we had the Japanese peony there that was absolutely gorgeous this spring, but now it's done and it just has the foliage. So a few more annuals, a couple of asters that have reseeded themselves.
These are daffodil leaves that I get tired of, so I braid them so they don't look quite so messy. This is where I planted my lupines that I got from Julie, and so far only one has come up. If I can find it, here it is, right here. Julie, I don't know what I did wrong, but only one so far. This is an aster that planted itself. Peach trees are doing very well, have little peaches on them. There's some right up there.
Yeah, there's quite a few. I'd see at least a couple dozen on this tree.
Yep. Hopefully a majority will make it through this summer. And then we have a little apricot tree that we added earlier. That one does not have any blossoms on it this year, but we're hoping for next year. I can see our trumpet vine is finally growing. It's been there for years and years, and this is the first time it's actually bloomed like that.
Yeah,
it's amazing. Another peach tree. Here's our strawberries that were tiny, tiny little maybe pencil sticks when we put them in, and they're just doing wonderfully. Some of them even have blossoms.
Any strawberries in there?
Let's see. Some green ones. Now these plants were from last year, the ones on this end. And always some weeds. There's one. Nice size. I'm going to wrap it around there so the ants don't get it. But we'll get some from the ones that were from last year, and then the new ones will come next year. And our garden is coming along. These are the end of the radishes. They were huge. Unfortunately, too hot for one of us.
For one of them.
To eat. That's a handsome radish. Have to put it in our salad. And we've got our broccoli is over there. We've got some cucumbers over here. The tomatoes. And you can see the alyssum is really taking off now, as are the marigolds. And then in the background there, you can see the peas climbing up their trellis. And in front of those are beans on the left and lima beans on the right. Now those I have put diatomaceous earth on. I didn't like, somebody's been chewing on my lima bean leaves. Then our carrots.
Pull one out. I want to see what they look like.
Mm-hmm. Look at that little beauty. Now this is one that we planted early in March with our hoop house. And it came out of the earth so nicely with all that sand in there. Perfect. Those are more cucumbers, more tomatoes.
And how many tomatoes do you have up here?
Oh dear. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and then a bunch of little tiny ones that I started from seed.
And these are those mostly the
these
cherry?
These are the berry tomatoes.
Berry tomatoes?
Yes, those are the berry tomatoes over there, and those are some heirlooms over there.
Okay.
And then this was my spinach that never came up. Well, one did. But then I planted some lettuce.
And this?
Those are turnips.
You want to pull one out?
Let me see.
See what happens.
They're awfully prickly. And they probably need thinning. They're coming along.
Yep.
This is our cotton plant. And I planted the whole package of cotton. See? You can sort of see it. Cotton plant. We did it so that Logan could see what cotton looked like when it grew, but only two of them have come up, so I don't know what that means. I forgot what this is. This is our pink pampas grass that has not come along yet.
Does it need more sun?
Well, it gets sun all morning.
Oh, that's true.
Mm-hmm. And these were some of the strawberries we sent away for. These were the tiny little sticks. They really like growing in these pots. Now, for those of you that might never have seen a raspberry blossom, this is what they look like when they're blossoming. That's the flower. And inside the flower is where the fruit comes from. And you can see all the little crevices where the seeds will be. These are our original raspberry bushes before we moved some. This area needs a little work. We've done the front. Now it's time to kind of reclaim the back again. So it just kind of goes from one area to the next. My herd of alliums. These were seeds that I just sprinkled down from last year's three bulbs that I had. I once planted snapdragons in here, and they seed themselves every year. I don't have to do anything about it. They just come back. And our little pond that we built back here, this afternoon, you couldn't even see the water. So I went in and I gave them all a haircut. But you can see the beautiful flowers that come and go. They last about a day. This is our plum tree.
Yeah, it looks like a bush.
We've not yet had any flowers on this one, but it's fairly new. I think this is only the second year.
Right.
So, and it was just a twig.
Want to talk about our ginkgo?
Oh, our ginkgo. Yes, our ginkgo gave us a big scare this spring. Ginkgos are very late in the year to get their leaves, and it was starting out like everything else a little bit earlier than usual, and they have their flowers first before the leaves. And I think what happened was the flowers got damaged when we had a really cold spell, and we looked at it and we thought, oh no, our ginkgo that's been here now how many years?
20?
Almost 20 years. We thought, oh no, we're losing it. So we ran over to our neighbors and looked at her ginkgo. And her ginkgo looked exactly the same as ours. So we figured, well, it can't just be ours. Something must have happened with the weather to make it that way. And sure enough, it's flowering out. It's leafing out just wonderfully now, as are Joyce's. So we're happy with you, ginkgo. Now, this is a bush that's amazing. It's not even a bush, it's a plant. It's called polymorphous, and it goes from absolutely nothing in the spring to taller than myself, and it's only the beginning of June. And it ends up with these beautiful flowers.
Tassels?
That smell to me like sort of like leather. They're really neat, and this will last all summer. These will turn brown, they'll be kind of pretty. So then I come in and I trim it all down to maybe this much. And then they will bloom again later on in the summer. And then come fall, it'll all die back down to the earth. So it's amazing. It's an amazing plant. It takes up a lot of space though. And this is our original pond. that we started with is from our Stein's Garden Center, put in 20 years ago when the ginkgo was put in. So we keep a few fish in there just to eat up the mosquitoes. And back here, right now you see it's lots of daisies. They'll be gone soon and then I'll pull them out. But this is where I put my squash again. Last year we had three kinds of squash in here and they took over the entire area. This time we have three groups again, so we'll see what happens on this one. Oh, wait, stop a minute. This is rose mallow. It's a very interesting, happy plant. It seeds itself, so it does spread around. Our friend John from the Bikers Club gave me some mallow seeds. They're called zebra mallows. So these seeds did come up. So I'm anxious to see what the flowers on those look like. Maybe they'll mingle. Maybe we'll get a cross pink and black and white stripes or something. Our apple tree, where our monkey usually sits. Keeps growing. We keep chopping. And our currants. Now this is where we're going to do another experiment because the currants, unfortunately, have aphids on them. And just today, Rick ordered some ladybugs in the mail. So we're going to get our ladybugs, follow the directions, and have them go after the aphids.
Well, you have 9,000 of them coming.
Oh boy.
And by the way, I was surprised to find that Kmart sold them.
Kmart the store?
Kmart the store, Kmart. The online.
Oh, yeah. .com. As does Home Depot.
Wow.
Yep.
And you have a pear tree back here?
Yes, I do have a pear tree. I don't see any pears.
I don't see any partridges.
No, that either. But they don't bloom every year, so. Now here's my rhubarb that's kind of taken over the area. We did plant, remember when we planted the asparagus? It did come up. Look at this. Now you're not supposed to pick it this year, so I'm not picking. Okay, this is our garlic that we planted, the little cloves of garlic. The other day I pulled one up just to see what it was like, and I used it like a green onion.
Well, you also have onions in here too,
these
right?
These are onions, yes. These are the onions. They're coming very nicely. Shall I pick one?
Sure.
See, I have them spaced so nicely here. I'll pick a big one. See? Very nice. Peel this back. Yep. Very nice. Good size. Perfect for a green onion. Tomatoes are doing well. They have blossoms. It's about time for me to come out and start pinching off the, giving them a haircut and pinching off the suckers. That's a whole nother story. Yes, I hear you, Mr. Robin.
And you have, what did we say, 52 tomatoes
50
in this area?
52 down here and then about 10 or 12 up there, plus baby ones. Plus we have some more, we're heavy on cucumbers this year. We have two things of cucumbers. These are lemon cucumbers. These are the little round yellow ones. We're looking forward to that. And over here we've got zucchinis. We got three hills of zucchini.
Well, you also have cantaloupe in here and watermelon too, right?
Yep. Follow me. Here are my peppers. I have banana peppers, a red, a yellow, an orange, and then the majority is green. I have my grass laid down as my compost. Got four eggplants. This is the cantaloupe. And, or maybe that, I forget what that is. One of these is watermelon. One is cantaloupe.
And I don't see any of your potatoes coming up yet.
Where are my potatoes? Now everybody tells me it's easy to grow potatoes, but I don't see any yet.
Maybe they were covered too much.
I tried
with
nothing.
Earth.
I suppose I could dig down and look, but I'm afraid.
Don't be afraid.
I'm very afraid. And over here is the raspberry patch that we so carefully tied up so that there would be a pathway in between. They filled out nicely. And you can see there's lots of blossoms in there. So that's good. And then this area is the blackberry bush or vine. And those two have multitudinous blossoms on them. I can already taste the blackberries. Yum. And then along the fence, you can see we still kept a little bit of our milkweed for the monarch butterflies. Now this is the north side. It's alongside of the garage. And right now we have hostas and peonies and a silver fern. In front of those, we are going to plant our peony tree seeds that are now in pots. Our friend Steve from China told us that this is the best way to get them to germinate and that they will germinate for us next spring after they've spent the winter in the ground with the snow. So we're going to push the mulch back, bury the pots in the soil, and then wait for next spring. I hope he's right.
Well, you've got 32 different varieties of peony trees and 1,000 seeds, so hopefully we'll get some germination.
Yep, I believe him. Now over here we've got our blueberries, and we have, how many did you say, 12 plants now?
11.
11 plants. They're coming along nicely. You can see they have berries on them. They made it through the winter fine. I've been putting cottonseed meal around them as well as worm castings. But just look at all these luscious blueberries that are coming. Hopefully a deer doesn't come right over here and just help himself. It's another beauty. And they're all different kinds like they recommend. And I've been putting pine needles. When we trimmed our pine tree, I saved some of the branches, and I've been spreading them around because the pine has the acid that they like. So we've been doing that. And behind us here are the grape vines. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 grape vines. And we're going to have to start getting these guys trimmed and trained, because they're getting a little crazy, but you can see they're going to flower. Each one of those hopefully will become a grape.
A cluster of grapes.
Yep, and I see somebody's been nibbling over here, and I know it's not a rabbit, and I know it's not a deer, so perhaps the ladybugs will be happy right here. Then you can see from this angle, you can see the raspberries and the blackberries.
And then over to the right, you have flowers and... back two more blueberry bushes here.
Right, these are where two of the blueberry bushes are. We have them caged. We've never had a problem with anybody chewing on them, but we're not taking chances. The flowers, these daisies, I think we started 1 year with daisies. And we had them up in front of the house, and they got carried away, and we pulled them out, and suddenly they're everywhere. They're beautiful. These are tiger lilies, which have just taken over this area.
Looks like they're ready to blossom.
They'll be going soon.
And then on the outside perimeter, you had
outside is the peonies, and they need trimming. All the old heads need to be trimmed off so that the energy goes back into the roots and not into making seeds.
And there's one of the evergreen trees that you transplanted 2 years ago.
Transplanted that one.
It's doing nicely.
Happy. It's being lost in the lilies, but hopefully it'll make them happy.
And look what made it.
And look at this pin oak that we had four of them. We now have this pin oak. And then we have, is that a pin oak over
yes.
there?
That's yep.
still tiny one stalk of pin oak. I keep adding acid to this one too.
And I see you're going to have more sunflowers.
Yes, of course.
What's a garden without sunflowers?
Exactly. Now, when they're tiny, sometimes the deer eat them, but they're getting to the point now where they're kind of prickly, so they won't bother them anymore. Here's our other pin oak. See, this one is what the problem is with them. And we were told that they don't have enough acid. We don't have enough acid in our soil for these guys.
Well, that's actually new growth.
I don't know.
Yes. Yep.
Maybe those are flowers.
That's new growth.
We can hope. Last summer, we had a Brookfield Garden Club meeting, the only one we ever had. But there, a woman, a very lovely lady named Sharon, came and she shared lilies with us. These are not the tiger lilies. They are a different kind of lily. And she gave us all these plants and some over there hiding amongst the daisies. So we're anxious to see what color they are. Well, we trimmed our bushes over here so we can see when we pull out of the driveway and so that they stay manicured. There's another polymorphous that I have to keep trimming because this is our pathway to the right here to get through to the front yard. That's a honeysuckle vine, which has just gone crazy this year, which I'm happy to say. And we were told that hummingbirds love them. I'm sure they do, but they come while we are not watching. So we haven't seen hummingbirds over here, but I'm sure they're loving them. Some of you may remember that last spring, a year ago, we had to cut down 16, 17 trees. And this is the wood. They were huge. This is the wood that came from them, probably 5 or 6 cords of wood. And we decided that we would use it in our landscaping as a natural fence. It keeps the dogs where they belong, and it gives a nice backdrop. And it kind of separates us, but not isolating us.
Well, we get so many comments about it when people come by and say, oh, what a great idea. You know, like mm-hmm. nobody's ever seen a wood cord fence before. Well,
and,
not in Brookfield.
Yep, and we have neighbors who, again, have shared. This spring, our neighbor Joyce asked us if we wanted some of her lilies. So I went over and we were able to dig up four lilies that she shared with us. And I think I chopped them into 12 pieces, at least 12. So I see that they are the lemon lilies. I wasn't quite sure, but you know, they look a little worn for having moved, but they'll be fine. They are really tough. And again, the daisies are crazy, but when they're done, then I will pull them out and somehow, miraculously, they'll come back. There, and over there is where the driveway is, and this just gives a nice natural entrance to the yard, and then kind of a mystery, like, what's on the other side of this? So it's kind of wilder, more dense out here, and more colorful and contained on the other side. Now we're back on the south side of the house again, and this is our little spring garden of daffodils and irises, and then the peony bush and the willow bush. Obviously, the iris need to have their old blossoms taken off. Always something to do. So here we are where we started again, the southwest corner of our yard. More peonies. Some were given to us by our neighbor Ruth, who is now up in heaven and smiling down on them, I hope. And sedums, hostas, ground cover,
another bush that needs trimming. Enjoyed our walkabout and have seen something that maybe has sparked an interest in you. When there's a garden, there's always work to do, but there's always something to share. So if you ever want to call or send a comment or ask a question, I'll do the best I can to answer. And bye for now. Enjoy.